Hello and welcome to the Love and Heal channel, where we believe to spread love and heal together. I am Pushkar, a part of our Love and Heal family. As we discussed energy healing in our last video, one of the most effective energy healing method was Reiki healing, and today we are going to know what is Reiki. If you haven't watched our last video, click on the I button and watch it. Reiki. Isn't it an intriguing concept? Let me try and explain what exactly Reiki is. So what does Reiki mean? When broken down, Rei means God's wisdom and Ki means energy. As explained in the last video, it was rediscovered in Japan by Dr. Mikao Usui, and it is an alternative health approach to stimulate our body's natural healing abilities. This means Reiki is for everyone, because everyone has Reiki. It is completely natural and accessible to all. Negative emotions overwhelm us and propel us into challenging situations where we end up in conflicts and face unknown issues. This state of uneasiness, which in the long run creates specific reactions in our bodies, gives rise to diseases that in turn cause pain and suffering. Reiki heals diseases of the physical body as well as our mental disorders. It can cure bad habits, psychological disorders like stress, anxiety, despair, fear, difficulty making decisions, and nervousness. With the Reiki energy, our soul gets cleansed and it becomes pure and graceful. How is Reiki practiced? Reiki is energy channeling through a healer to recipient's body. The healer scans the patient's aura or chakras, which means vital energy centers of the body, and senses the blockages. Initially, the healer may inquire the patient about pain points, if he or she has any. If the patient is not vocal or comfortable in describing pain points, then the healer, through his or her expertise, analyzes which points of the patient's body require healing. Reiki, that is energy offered through light. Non-invasive touch with the practitioner's hand placed and held on different locations like the head or any specific part of the body which has pain. The placement of the hands should not have any pressure. This is the Reiki's healing touch through healer's palms on the recipient's body. Energy then heals the patient on the mental, physical, and emotional planes. This can also be achieved through distance healing. What is distance healing? Distance healing is the healing given by the healer to the recipient by using the Reiki symbols irrespective of the physical distance between both of them. How is distance Reiki healing practiced? Let us understand this through an example of posting a letter to your loved one. First, you will write your message on a piece of paper. You will require the contact number and the address of the receiver. Then you attach a stamp to the letter and then you post it to your loved one. So now, consider the piece of paper as a healer and the message as the healing energy. The content of the letter is the essence. The healing energy is the essence. A healer is just a medium to shower you with the healing energy that he or she receives from the divine force. Here, the patient's photograph, contact number, and an address is required for the healer to practice the technique. The healer then stamps beautiful positive affirmations while healing the patient. How can we do Reiki healing using crystals? There is also one common practice to use different stones and crystals like topaz, rose quartz, amethyst, moonstones, aquamarine, etc. while healing. Crystals have innate energy of their own. They bring everything to balance and help in speeding up the body's natural healing ability. They also amplify the healing energies when we combine the crystals with Reiki. Different crystals have different qualities and can be used as an aid in healing a patient with specific ailments. So using crystals help in calming the patient's mind as well as speed up the healing process. What are the principles of Reiki? The philosophy of Reiki is based on 5 principles. These principles guide healing and balancing energies. The 5 Reiki ideals are as follows. Just for today, I will not be angry. Just for today, I will not worry. Just for today, I will be grateful for all my blessings. Just for today, I will do my work honestly. And just for today, I will be kind to others. Dr. Mikao Usui taught us to follow the above Reiki ideals. We should meditate on them deeply to understand their true meaning and follow this practice in our daily lives. As someone has previously said, life without a principle is like a journey without a map and direction, and without proper direction we may get lost. The principal purpose that Dr. Usui promoted was to heal the spirit. He realized that without healing the soul first, physical life could not remain peaceful and happy. Dr. Usui rediscovered and bestowed us with the power of Reiki, essentially a way to live life. We can get rid of suffering by following and living our life as per the following Reiki principles. As a result, we can feel spiritual awakening, realize the soul's supreme qualities, and live life of fullness, peace, and happiness. Let us know each one of them closely. The first one, which states, just for today, I'll not be angry, which can also be transcribed as, today, I will release any angry thoughts. It's normal to feel angry sometimes. This might be triggered by any situation or a person. But according to Reiki, anger does not come from external events. Instead, it comes from within. So this principle helps one release this negative energy. It encourages you to recognize anger and let it go, so that you can allow happiness and peace in your life. The second principle states, just for today, I will not worry, which can also be transcribed as, today, I will release any thoughts of worry. Many of us worry about things that haven't even happened yet. And while it is easy to feel that way, in Reiki, it is said that worry also comes from within. So holding on to worry, thinking about the future, produces negative energy. However, if one can let go of this, you might have an easier time focusing on the present. In Reiki, actively practicing mindfulness or expanding our consciousness means the act of being aware and present in the now is the key to balancing your energy. This principle encourages you to recognize how often we get lost in our thoughts and how we should remind ourselves to focus on the present. The third principle states, just for today, I will be grateful. This is a reminder to be thankful for all that we have. As long as we are breathing, we can change our circumstances. So there can never be anything that you cannot be grateful for. The fourth principle states, just for today, I will do my work honestly. One should do their work with total devotion. Just surrender to Reiki energy and work towards healing yourself and others. The fifth principle is, just for today, I will be kind to others, which can also be transcribed as, today, I will be gentle with all living and non-living beings. This principle is a reminder that when we spread positivity, happiness, and kindness, that's exactly what we get in return. This is also a reminder to be kind to ourselves, which is essential for spiritual health and also overall well-being. Be kind to everything. Be loving to all living and non-living things. Genuine compassion is not only feeling someone's pain, but also being able to help relieve it. How is this beneficial? This is beneficial in many ways. It is known to heal anxiety and fatigue, treats depression, boosts or enhances a person's mood and improves the quality of life. It can also aid in healing some conditions like headache, insomnia, nausea by allowing the obstructed energy in you to flow gracefully. I can still remember my first Reiki experience. The first session felt a lot like an assisted nap. I felt warmth. I drifted in and out of light sleep. And at times, I saw flashes of light. In general, I would describe it as a meditative-like state where very few thoughts ran through my head and I was deeply relaxed. I felt refreshed, as if I took a power nap. The pain sensations reduced as well. Many people think this is a placebo effect, but I have taken and given healing since 20 years. And every time I use Reiki, it has intrigued me with its powerful capabilities. I have really grown in different aspects of my life due to the Reiki energy, and I am grateful I have had a taste of it. So guys, this is how Reiki works. I would like to conclude by saying Reiki is an amazingly simple yet powerful form of spiritual healing. And one should only experience it from a professional Reiki practitioner. Hope this video was helpful. Stay tuned to our channel for more such videos. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Love and Heal. Keep spreading the love, folks.